Well, hey folks, how y'all doing? Welcome back. Yeah, we're at another Weber product here. We got the Weber Smoky Joe. This is the smallest of the Weber products that are made. These things sell like crazy. 20, 30 bucks, you can pick them up all the time. What we're going to be doing is a mod with this. And what I want to do is if you've watched my videos before, you've seen that I've modified to put a grill stone for the 22 inch, which I bought. Barbecue Dragon sells those, but what they don't make is one for the 18-inch Jumbo Joe. So I took one of their own, the Barbecue Dragon one, and modified it to fit that. You can see that Tom Horseman on YouTube. So now I bought myself another, this is just a pizza stone that I found relatively cheap. And what I want to do is I want to modify it here to fit the Smoky Joe. So it fits down a little bit lower. And I've always already got the way to keep the charcoal going here. We got one of these Weber charcoal holders that fits on the bottom grate that hold the charcoal in, and it gives me about one third of the space, and the other two thirds will be actually my cooking space. And you're saying, well, why do you need a grill stone on there? Well, it's all about thermal mass, and it helps. That thermal mass helps even out your temperatures, gives you a indirect cooking side. And just does my personal experiences using it on the Jumbo Joe and on the Weber 22 inch. Like I said, you can buy one for the Weber 22 inch from Barbecue Dragon. And like I said, nobody makes them for the Smoky Joe or for the Jumbo Joe. Otherwise, I would have purchased them. And that's why I'm doing the modification to show you how you can do it. Because remember, if I can do it, you can do it also. So stay tuned. We'll show you how that all goes. All right, the first thing you want to do is make yourself a template. I just got a piece of cardboard here. Obviously, I'm going to keep on cutting on this to get it so it fits nicely. Obviously, I don't want to just start cutting away at the ceramic because if I screw it up, then, it's just scrap. So keep on going. Give you a look-see. All right, there we go, folks. There's what I did so far. It fits. This is why this is why I use cardboard, because I took a little bit too much off on these ends here, but I've marked with pencils, when I transfer it on, I know I'm going to leave a little bit more there. And I can always trim it down or sand it off a little bit. But I want it to be at about the same level as the height of the grill rack. And that'll still leave the charcoal separator. And that'll still leave room for the grill to sit up here. So I think this will work. So I tell you what, let's lay this out and get to cutting, shall we? All right, folks, we're just about ready to start cutting here. Before I start, if you're going to do this and you don't feel comfortable using power tools, then don't. Make sure you follow the safety procedures for your power tools. Remember, this is going to be causing dust, so you may want to wear some sort of dust mask. If you're curious about what type of blade we're using here, this is a Bosch blade, and it's for cutting cement board. And it's used it before, and it does a great job. So let's get the cutting. All right, folks, there's the final product there. I always cut two little hand holes in there. That way you can get some fingers in there and pull it off, more or less for putting it on, because you're pulling it off. It could be hot. You always let it cool down. But I tell you what, this is going to really supercharge the Smoky Joe grill. See how it goes in there? Fits in there nicely. Charcoal on this side, indirect on this side. You got a stone there. Add some thermal mass to this little charcoal grill. It's going to, like I said, it's going to supercharge it. It's going to work great. And, folks, I tell you what, I'll leave the link down in the comments section to the other one I did for the Jumbo Joe, so you can see what I've did. Once again, I've said this before, if I can do it, you can do it. Super simple. You want to make your Smoky Joe better than what it already is. You know, make your Jumbo Joe better than what it already is. Super simple to do. Tom Horseman at YouTube, leave a comment, thumbs up, please subscribe. And as always, I can't say it enough. Thanks for watching. I really do appreciate it.